Good evening to all, and thank you for being here. Thank you to the Commissioner and the Honorable Milling Espat, Mr. Sib, Mr. Vidal, and Mr. Gamboa. Thank you for being here, and Ms. Book. Thank you too, and thank you to all for being here. I have some announcements to make that we have been working together with some of the groups around community and with the law enforcement. So some of the things that we want to announce is that with the help of the people that people have been helping around, is that a new checkpoint was donated, a checkpoint house was donated by Mr. Rajiv Pacheco. And at the same time, the town council and Mr. Rajiv Pacheco got in an agreement, and we went ahead and we got the Helpage House to allocate the personnel from the law enforcement. So that has been done, and we have, I think we are doing 3 months for them right there, and I don't know if you will be around for more time, and if that is the case, we will continue for the rental. And a donation for the same boot was done by the Benke Hardware by Mr. Eric Juan for the Rotoplas, so to have water at the boot. And at the same time, this weekend, me as a constructor, I will go ahead and do a little work on the weekend and try to build that septic in maybe 1.5 days and try it, have it ready for Monday for the police to be there and for it to be used. So we will have the road plus and the septic this weekend installed and ready to operate on Monday. We have been in together with the cooperation with Mr. Moreno. We went around and on the Riverside area where the delinquency has happened and the criminal acts have been taking part. So Mr. Moreno and town council have gone around checking the trees that we need to trim for more light to be, and he has promised us that the lights will be changed all on the area of the Riverside streets for a brighter street on that area for criminality to lower down and to make it safer for town on that area. And I have asked him too that on the area of the Old Borough Road, there we went around on Saturday together with the town administrator and one or two of the councillors. We went around checking on the dark spots, and I was commenting to Mr. Moreno if this could happen. And he said it could be a possibility to get everything brightened on that area too, because those areas have been a little bit of an impact to the police too. There was a case about 2 months ago that something happened there was not really good. And after that, things have been happening around in Benke. And at the same time, we will be removing, as a town council, we will be removing vehicles that are not operating, and whosoever owns the vehicles, if they are hearing or they know about it, that we will be removing the vehicles, is even if they have it there, and if they say there it's their property, we'll either push it in their land or we will take it away, because some of these vehicles have been hiding places for weapons which are not licensed and for people that are doing illegal stuff. So these vehicles will be removed, and at the same time we pass a resolution on the Benkeville Town Council on people who are having lots, our own lots that are bushy. And one of the things that we will do, we will put this on the Facebook page beginning on Monday, and we will give 14 days to these people who own bushy lots and who are the proprietors of these bushy lots. If they don't cut down the bushes on their premises, we will go forward and we will cut them, and then we will put a bill. If they don't want to pay, they will still pay through the property taxes. So that will be one of the things that we have resolved together with the town council members, and this will be a resolution passed on as from Monday, that we will take care of this to bring down the hideaways of these criminals. And at the same time,
Thank you.
We will work together with the people and with the police, and thanks to Mr. Gibran for helping the with the lights of to the commissioner on the vehicle that he put on Benke, and thanks to there's another person that gave something as some radios Mr. Gibran gave too, so we thank him too for that. For Ms. Carissa donating the phones for the police at the meanwhile that I think the smartphones, Ms. Carissa, that you donated, so thank you very much for that. And I would like to thank everybody for putting a big effort in Benke, and I would thank to everybody in the cooperation, and I think if we work together, things could happen in Benke for a better and a safer Benke Viejo town. So I thank you everybody, and I thank the Honorable Milin Espat for his efforts and the works that he will be complying with the ministers. I thank him too for that very much. And I think with his help, we will be having Benke in a brighter future. Thank you.